working in Ontario, and it makes many nurses leave the profession.
Healthcare.
Valued without pay.
Yeah. legislation. They will attempt to privatize our public hospitals.
Healthcare system that's collapsing. Doug Ford thought he could intimidate you. He decided to save money and create a crisis in our healthcare system so a few rich people, a few rich investors, could make a buck off it. In the courts against you, and he's gonna lose in the court of public opinion every single time.
Oh, okay.
Communities out there across this province, they've got your back. We've got your back. Yeah. The amazing organizing work they're doing all across this province. And I want you to know that's what we're going to do too. Because we can't afford to let them get away with this. We are the party of Tommy Douglas. And we're going to keep standing up for patients, standing up for communities. Corner of this province so we can not only hold these guys to account every single day, but we're going to defeat them in 2026. You guys, we're going to be the next governor of Ontario. We're going to stand with you. They heard your story day in and day out, how you need more nurses, more healthcare workers, more time to take care of our patients properly. We Ontarians deserve it. They need more time, more nursing care, more healthcare worker time. And the NDP heard it. So now let's continue in our speeches. Right here in downtown Toronto, you have the Secretary Treasurer of the Canadian Labour Congress, representing over 300 workers, Julie Chan.
More than 3 million workers from coast to coast to coast, I want to let you know that we are standing in solidarity with ONA and with all the nurses across this country who are bargaining right now. Better, better wages, better staffing, because that means better care for all of us. Working with full staffing levels. that we can be safe and so we can be healthy. And so it's time for all of us to step up and be there for them. For better staffing, for better wages.
because when workers are united, we are never defeated. Workers united will never be defeated.
Workers united will never be defeated. Workers united.
Let me see your signs and your flags. Now I want to hear from allies. Right. I'm going to ask something of our friends and our allies. It's no longer that we can be allies. We need to be co-conspirators. And when Ona needs us, we will shut it down.
Secondary school teachers. Sarah, I can't see you.
shaky up there. Even in minus 30 below last week in Ottawa at the rally, they were there with us. So we won't stop. Wait, won't stop.
I still remain, I am the daughter of a nurse. Everything I know about tenacity, about resiliency, about pushing back, about being a caring individual and making sure that you are putting this city comes from that amazing nurse, Sue Monroe. I had 55,000 of my best friends, along with thousands of our other friends, and we were told by this Ford government, if we did not withdraw our strike mandate, they would legislate a contract on us, and they would remove our ability to strike. And friends, 55,000 workers in QB, as well as thousands from OPSU, looked at the Ford government and we said, try us. Across this province, the lowest paid education workers went on an illegal strike and they told Ford no.
And we respect you, we respect the work that you do, and we're going to stand side by side with you for better wages, better staffing, and better care. I want you to know that our members are standing in solidarity with you, and want nurses and healthcare workers to know that you are the background in Ontario's public healthcare system. And we know that you're the one that kept our healthcare system going, despite the impossible circumstances that you're placed in time and time again. I want to shout out the nurses that have been instrumental in helping my family, the nurses at Starville Channel, thank you. Hospital, thank you. When my father was sick this summer, nurses were there to support our family by his side. We appreciate you. We thank you. You have an impact on every Ontarian. And I've seen as one to have that direct impact on your care for the system and for the people that you work with. In those 2 incidents of misconservative government, particularly undervalued those in the profession, which women make up and are largely the majority of workers. This is a case both in public health care and public education. Shame on this government. Shame for trying to undervalue the work that you do every day. Shame on them. So today we are adding our voices to yours and demanding that the Ford government stop its attack on public health care and give you the respect that you deserve. As you know, we've had many battles to stop Ford with elected premier. One of the things we have learned over the past 2 years is that when we organize and fight, we win. What? When we organize and fight, we win! When we organize and fight,
we win!
When we organize and fight,
we win!
Solidarity, solidarity, we win!
They gave me a mic, I'm a labor leader, a female, and French, like really, I'll be here forever. And now talking about a labor leader who's French and who could talk forever, who is the executive assistant of my dear friend, Lana Payne, Roxanne Dubois from Unifor.
I hope you're doing well. Corps members from across Canada. Our national president, Lana Payne, who today is with healthcare members who, just like you, have been facing the front lines of the healthcare crisis for far too long. I'm here to tell the folks in the building behind us that you deserve better. We know that you're fighting for better wages. We know that you're fighting for better care. We know that you're fighting for public health care. And public health care is a right. We will not give up the fight. Unifor stands with you. Solidarity and massive deployment.
Mark from Local 75, raise your hand. You're going to miss your bus. I have a very important job here. So Mark from Local 75, get your bus. Okay. So now, we have a question. Mike Schreiner, the leader of the Green Party of Ontario.
And I want to tell you, what I told the Premier during the leaders' debate, if he'd ever met a nurse, and he had trouble answering that, I want to welcome him out here right now to meet the nurses! I want Doug Thorne to come out here and talk to heroes so he can learn how to treat heroes. People who care for us, not shareholders. And so the only thing that's going to stop this government is the people power and worker power we're seeing here today. And I just want you to know the Ontario Greens, we're ready to work with the opposition parties to stand in solidarity with you, to push back on this government, defeat them, and to stand up for the people of this province, to stand up for public health care, and ensure the nurses get the wages you deserve. Thank you for being here today. Here we are. I'm staring down Hospital Alley. I'm looking
that
Canadians should be so proud of. You know, we have the most educated healthcare workforce in the world. We have a public healthcare system that is the envy of much of the world. And yet, today at 4 o'clock, most of the operating rooms in those hospitals will shut down, and they won't open up again until tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock when they'll commence operations again. Because why? Because the government will not fund them to run all out to clear the backlog of surgeries and diagnostic care that we need. And why? Because it takes people to provide health care. You know, we used to have a nurse, an old nurse matron. Her name was Helen Havelick, and she was the old nurse matron of the Petrolia Hospital before they got it in services. And she used to tell me, there isn't a hospital without a nurse. Nurses make hospital care. That is what defines a hospital. Underspent its healthcare budget last year by $860 million. $860 million while keeping a wage cap on the nurses and health professionals, support staff in the public and not-for-profit healthcare system that are vital to do the work that we need, even as patients are languishing on longer and longer and longer wait lists and paying more and more and more out of pocket to seek care in these private, predatory companies that are now emerging across Ontario to sell us on healthcare in violation of the core tenets of public Medicare in this country, that you should never be charged for medically needed healthcare services. Legislature came out with its updated report. In the first 9 months of this financial year, they are now underspent in health care by $1.25 billion. That's $1.25 billion that they could have spent to help our public hospitals, our public long-term care, our home care, and they chose not to. Clinics while they're starving our public healthcare system. You would think that they were driving it into the ground on purpose, or they're completely incompetent, but there is no other choice here. It's one or the other, so Doug Ford, which is it? Are you the most incompetent government we have ever seen? We have the worst shortages of staffing that we have ever seen in the history of healthcare in this province. We had 158 emergency department closures over the last year, and yet we're underspent by more than $1.25 billion in healthcare. It's a plan to defund, create chaos, do nothing to support the workforce, and privatize healthcare. And we need to send the message, and you started today, that the fight back starts here. We will not tolerate it. The conditions of work for you are the conditions of care for us. We are in full solidarity. We will fight everything it takes to stop the Ford government from destroying our public health care. Thank you so much.
Here, and this is pretty unbelievable. So, I don't know about you, but I believe we will win. So, I'm going to say I, and I want to hear you repeat after me. Everything I say, you're going to repeat. Politicians. And then we get our voices louder and louder and louder in unity. So are we ready?
Yeah!
We'll be back. We'll